we heard from AD, didn't we, when England failed to qualify. It was always going to be a little bit difficult, and there was speculation, who's going to get it? Will Frank Lampard fancy it, etc., etc.? Was that a surprise to you?
No, not at all. No. I mean, he had to perform. It's all about major competitions that you trying to nurse the players, and the results weren't good enough. So I think AD's very realistic man. He knows, you know, that was the end of him. It'd be interesting to see who they go for now. Because
yeah.
Will they go for a young England player, ex-player, who you've got to look at who can probably be potentially England manager going forward?
Well, Frank,
That's how you've got to look at it. If I was trying to pick a manager, and look, some managers won't want the job, I don't know, but certainly, that's why you've got to be looking at. Gareth Southgate started young and lower teams. And look at him now. He's now the England manager. So I'll be looking along there. No disrespect to AD Boothroyd. He was never going to be England manager going forward. So
Trev,
that was a strange
one anyway. Any ideas right away? Is Frank looking for a big Premier club, or may decide, OK, that'll do me for now, and it's a stepping stone?
Yeah, he might decide that this is a good stepping stone for him, Frank. But looking at the fact that he's been at Chelsea, he's been at Derby, he might want more of that day-to-day management. Because I think that's where you learn your bread and butter as a coach and as a manager. The England squad, when you're 21, what do they get together? 4 or 5 times a year. So if Frank goes there, listen, I don't think it was by design from the FA, but the way that Gareth's done it, it could become the blueprint for future managers of the England senior side. I'd like to see a Joe Cole. You know, I was just saying to Ben off air, the producer, that Joe Cole, his name was branded about. I'd love to see Joe Cole go in there, because I just feel someone like that would have a good affiliation with the players. Obviously, he was a child protege. I used to call him the conjurer. He was so talented. And you need someone in there who's going to be able to have a good relationship with the players, and who's going to be able to inspire them to good performances. But 3 wins in 21 games for the under-21s in European qualifying games, not good enough. Listen, AD had a good go at it. He weren't quite good enough, and it didn't go quite well enough for him. So I think the time's right for it to move on and get a new person in at that top.
You wouldn't mind having a little involvement there, would you, Trev?
I'd love it, yeah. No, listen, I've been coaching now, best part of 13 years since I retired, pretty much straight away. I've learnt my trade, I've been at it, you know, gone through all the badges, I've got my UEFA. I'd love to work with elite players. I work with players that have gone on to become pro. I've worked with young players that, you know, they're not really showing that kind of quality, but you can still teach them, you can still help them, and that's what I've enjoyed. But I think when you're working with the 21s, you're talking about elite players, and it's about structure, it's about how you set up, the players understanding what's necessary when they go out there, and they're still young players, so they're still learning, so there's still that little bit of teaching that you can do even when they come in to see you for that brief time. So yeah, it'd be something that I'd be very interested in.